Hello, and welcome to another episode of Brettcast Movie and TV Talk. Since it's the spooky month of October, and the day this is posted, it's going to be Halloween. So why not watch some spooky stuff and talk about it? Yes, I know that what I am talking about isn't really that spooky, but I'm still going to talk about it anyway. This is the follow-up to my previous video, in which I'm going to be talking about Saw 5 through 8. AKA Jigsaw. Remember, there will be spoilers for all of these movies. I'm going to do my best to go through the plots of these movies since it's been a few now since I've seen them, and the plots are so tightly wound that it's hard for me to remember what happened and what and which thing happened in what movie. Starting with Saw 5, the opening trap with a man by the name of Seth. What is called the pendulum trap. Basically, there's a blade on a pendulum that, unless Seth uses the two devices on either side of his hands to completely crush his hands, the blade will lower slowly and will cut Seth in half. The thing is that Seth does willingly crush his own hands, yet still gets cut in half. The first half of the plot of this movie is about Agent Strom trying to catch Mark Hoffman, who is the current person under the Jigsaw alias. The other part of the plot for this movie is the group of five people that get trapped and have to go through a series of tests. We start with them in a room being faced with the keys to unlock their collars, but if they go for the keys, a timer will start giving each person only 60 seconds to get their key and free. Otherwise, the person will get pulled back and lose their heads, literally. The next room, where they have to smash glass jars to find keys that will open some safe spaces to hide in before nail bombs go off. Thing is that the group isn't smart, and pretty much one person gets killed in each trap, which really hurts them in the final trap, where two people have to bleed enough blood to fill some jars, and the trap, like all trap this group goes through, are for five people. But one guy basically messes up his entire arm and dies from it, while the other woman only cuts herself a bit and survives it in terms of who gives the most blood. In the end, Strom thinks he catches Hoffman, but then he punches Hoffman into a box that lowers Hoffman into the floor and safe, while Strom gets literally squished as the walls of the room slowly close in and kill him. If only Strom had heard all of the tape that Hoffman was listening to, maybe he would have survived. Saw 6 opens with two people in a trap where in 60 seconds they have to cut off enough flesh to put it on a scale, and whoever puts the most on the scale gets free, and the woman cuts her entire arm off and goes free while the guy ends up dying. Part of this plot of this movie involves a set of envelopes that is in the possession of John's ex-wife, Jill Tuck. Jill meets up with Hoffman and she gives him most of the envelopes, but not all of them, which will be important to the end of the movie. The other part of the plot for the movie involves a man by the name of William, who is an executive at a health insurance company that has a horrible system that denies coverage to people who really need it and give coverage to people who are fairly healthy because of some system that he designed himself. William gets put through a series of tests along with other co-workers in his office. He has to do a lot of deciding which of his co-workers will live or die because it's Saw. In the end, we get to see a flashback where Amanda had her boyfriend go in and rob Jill's clinic, which led to her stomach getting smacked while she was pregnant. And then we see the final envelope that Jill kept for herself was a picture of Hoffman, so she knocks him out and puts Hoover's bear trap on him. However, Hoffman is able to get free of the trap with sacrificing some of his own face as well. Then we come to Saw 3D, the final chapter, which I will refer to as Saw 7 if I have to mention the title of the movie later on. This movie has an interesting opening trap that is set up in a public space and sees two men that have been played by the same woman decide if one of the guys will die or if both of the guys will just choose to kill the woman that's been cheating on both of them, and that's what they choose to do. Part of the plot to this movie involves this really horrible guy that claims to be the survivor of the Saw trap that has this little group of survivor meeting that for some reason he is filming. It's honestly really scummy, but mirrors what some people do IRL by exploiting an ordeal someone went through for profit gain, even though they themselves have never gone through anything like that. Anyway, this man, Bobby, gets kidnapped and put through a series of traps, all with the goal of getting to see his wife, who is waiting for him at the end. Of course, she's also trapped. The other part of the plot is the continuing rivalry between Mark Hoffman and Jill Tuck, and this ends with Hoffman using the reverse bear trap on Jill and ends up killing her. Also, Bobby ends up failing his trial and gets to see his wife cooked to death. And we also see in the movie, the big twist is that Dr. Lawrence lived and became one of John's assistants by helping with all of like the medical side of various traps throughout all of the movie. And that's how the movie ends. Finally, we come to Jigsaw, or Saw 8, if you want to call it that. The first part of the plot of this movie is a group of people that are put through a series of traps within a barn that is owned by Jill Tuck's family, of course, was converted by John for his own sick, twisted game. The other part of the plot involves getting to see another one of John's secret apprentices, Logan, who was the one who helped John build the reverse bear trap that gets used on Jill to kill her. Logan is like a police officer that sees other officers being dirty cops, and he takes action by using the farmhouse that John used over 10 years ago on a new group of people. The twist is that 10 years ago, Logan was actually one of the people that John had in the farmhouse, made it look like he had died, but John actually saves him. In the end, Logan actually uses a fake out to get the dirty cop to confess everything he has done, and yet the dirty cop gets killed anyways. So, what did I think of Saw 5 through 8? I'm gonna start with the fact that Saw 7 is definitely the weakest of all of these movies for a lot of reasons that I'm going to explain. The biggest issue with the movie is that it has this incredibly fake look to it. They made all of the blood pink, and the reason is because of the fact that they thought the 3D glasses would darken the movie, so with glasses it should look red. And that's all well and good for people watching the movie in 3D, but they should have definitely considered that people would see it not in 3D, and more people would have probably seen this movie not in 3D than in 3D. There were some moments in this movie where something would happen and you could tell it was one of those like shots meant for 3D, like something getting thrown in slow motion or whatever, and it's coming like right at the camera, and it's made for 3D. This movie just looks so fake that it really hurts the movie, even if the story is interesting, which it is. There are some things that it's like, why did we have to wait so long to get to see this happen or this character return? We have to wait so many movies before Lawrence returns, even though other survivors return to the franchise much faster. Also, why do we go like 7 to 8 movies before getting to see only one reverse bear trap kill? I also really want to know what happened to Lawrence after his return in the 7th or 8th movie. Sure, we see that he helps John with the medical side of all of his traps, but I want to know if there's more to it than that. Something that I have come to the conclusion of with these movies is that while Hoffman does better at being the Jigsaw killer than Amanda, neither of them really carry on what John's traps were like or how John would pick his victims based on his ideals. Like, Logan did a little bit better, but he just reused an old series of traps that John himself used years ago, so it doesn't really count because he didn't have to put that much effort into it. Again, these movies are very bloody and gruesome and violent and are not for everyone. I myself did have to look away from the majority of the traps as they crossed the threshold of how much gore I can handle at once. The stories are interesting, and again, I have to give these movies credit that they do keep their continuity nice and tight. And the only negative thing about that is that I can never remember what happens in what movie, and I get them mixed up, which I probably did somewhere here. Saw 5 through 8 are good movies that I do recommend watching. That's all I have to say, so if you like what you're seeing here, feel free to subscribe. If you want to add to the conversation, leave a comment below. As always, thanks for listening, and goodbye.